Dear students, we are dealing with molecular spectroscopy chapter, and in this we have seen about the dipole moment, then rotational spectroscopy, and now we are dealing with vibrational spectroscopy. In vibrational spectroscopy, we have seen about the simple harmonic oscillator, the energy levels of vibrations that the molecule undergoes. Then we have also seen about the P branch and R branch lines. In our last lecture, we had seen about this P branch and R branch lines. Now, in this moving forward, we will see about the unharmonic oscillator in this lecture. Dear students, when we had seen about the harmonic oscillator, we had assumed that whenever a molecule is undergoing, when the molecule is undergoing vibrational motions, it gets compressed or it gets extended or the expanded. The bomb atoms get the bond get expanded or it get compressed from its original equilibrium position. So in this case, what we had assumed that in a simple harmonic model, we had assumed that these two are the balls that are representing the atoms which are connected through a spring type of a bond, which is represented by a spring. So our simple harmonic oscillator was somewhat like this, where we had tied a weight over here, and this weight was representing one bond, one atom, and this fixed was representing another atom, and this spring was representing the bond. Now in this case, what was we had done was that this spring we had assumed that that to be completely elastic. And we had assumed that the bond is also behaving like an elastic one, so that the amount of compression is same as the amount of expansion. Lekin actual practices mein aisa nahi hota hai. Actual practices mein kya hota hai ki jitna aapka expansion hota hai usse thoda kam compression hota hai. Bond ka jo compression hota hai wo thoda sa kam hoga compared to expansion. This is because कि जब भी एटम्स बॉन्ड जब कंप्रेस होता है तो एटम्स दोनों नजदीक आते हैं. लाइक इन दिस केस, दिस इज आवर इक्विलिब्रियम पोजीशन, दिस इज आवर कंप्रेस्ड पोजीशन. नाउ कंप्रेस्ड पोजीशन में दोनों एटम्स दे आर कमिंग टुगेदर नियरर टू ईच अदर. इन दैट केसेस व्हाट हैपेंस इज द इलेक्ट्रॉन क्लाउड ऑफ वन एटम एंड द इलेक्ट्रॉन क्लाउड ऑफ अनदर एटम आर वेरी क्लोज टुगेदर. सिमिलरली देयर न्यूक्लियस आर ऑल्सो वेरी क्लोज टुगेदर, सो दे विल रिजल्ट इन repulsion. They will result in repulsion of the charges, and so we need a very high energy to overcome these repulsions. So to get the amount of amount of compression at a particular level, we need more energy than what is expected. So एक्सपेंशन में जब हम करते हैं तो एक्सपेंशन में क्या होता है कि ओवरलैप ऑफ दिस ऑर्बिटल्स इज डिक्रीज्ड, ओवरलैप ऑफ ऑर्बिटल डिक्रीजेस, बट देयर इज नो रिपल्शन दैट इज कमिंग अप. अट्रैक्टिव फोर्सेस आर डिक्रीजिंग ओवर दैट. सो एक्सपेंशन हमारा थोड़ा सा ज्यादा होता है और रिपल्शन जो कंप्रेशन होता है वो रिपल्शन की वजह से थोड़ा कम होता है इन एक्चुअल प्रैक्टिस. सो दैट पिक्चर वी कॉल इट एज ए अनहार्मोनिक ऑसिलेटर. We call it as an unharmonic oscillator, and this is represented by the potential that is arising through this is represented by an unharmonic oscillation potential, like with this particular diagram, where these dashed lines are for harmonic oscillator. While the solid lines are representing the unharmonic oscillator. In this picture, we can see that there is a little lesser compression. Actually, it should have been up to this point, but it is actually coming over here. So, ये जो gap है, ये gap इतना कम compress होता है bond, लेकिन expansion में उतना ज़्यादा expand होता है. So overall, when we see this, observe this particular well, potential well, we can see that at lower energy levels, at lower vibrational energy levels, it is having no difference, or it is very much similar to that of harmonic potentials. But when we go higher in energy, there is larger and larger gaps are deviations are being observed in this case. And the result of this is that in a harmonic potential, the energy gap between any vibrational energy levels was equal, but यहाँ पे energy gap decrease होता है. Unharmonic oscillators में energy gap decrease होता है, and we can get the energy of unharmonic oscillator. The energy levels of unharmonic oscillators can be represented by the equation E vibrations equals to B plus half into H nu zero. This is our normal harmonic potential harmonic oscillators energy, which we are having now unharmonic oscillator. So it will have minus B plus half whole square H nu zero XE, where we have this XE, which is called as unharmonicity constant. This is called as unharmonicity constant, and its values are of the order of 10 raised to minus 2. While we have this nu zero is fundamental frequency of vibration, fundamental vibrational frequency, which is of the order of 10 raised to 5 per meter, and this is of the order of 10 raised to minus 1 minus 2 per meter. So we can say that this XE, or the unharmonicity constant, is much smaller than that of the fundamental vibrational frequency. So the effect is very small, but still there is an effect. Effect is smaller, but it is there is certain effect that is observed because of this unharmonic oscillations. We will see now the energy changes in this unharmonic oscillator. For unharmonic oscillator, how are the energy changes are occurring? So from this fundamental equation E vibration, this equation using, we can get the energies associated with the vibrations occurring in the unharmonic oscillators. So whenever we will see first the expression for change in the vibrational energy of an unharmonic oscillator. Now, for this, what we can say is that we have this E is equal to equation 1, we have it. E vibration equals to V plus half H nu zero minus V plus half whole square H nu zero X. Our delta E, that is change in energy, will be equal to E2 minus E1. So E2 represents the vibrational energy level V2, and E1 represents the vibrational energy level V1. So we will have this delta E will be given as E2 will be V2 plus half H nu zero minus V2 plus half whole square H nu zero XT. This is our E2 minus E1 will be V1 plus half H nu zero minus V1 plus half whole square H nu zero XT. Now when we simplify this, this xe terms we can take it together, and h nu zero terms can be taken up together, so that similar quantities can be taken up together. We will have it delta e will be equal to v2 plus half h nu zero minus v1 plus half h nu zero. As this is minus between e2 and e1, so this term will become minus over here. So we will have this particular terms associated here. Then we will have plus this particular term. If we have it minus over here, we have a minus over here, then this minus will be coming over here. So we will have it here as v2 plus half whole square h nu 0 xe minus v1 plus half whole square h nu 0 xe. When we expand this, h nu 0 is common in this, so that we can take it outside from the first bracket. We will have v2 plus half, this will be minus v1 minus half into h nu 0 minus, here we can take h nu 0 and xe as outside, v2 plus half whole square minus v1 plus half whole square into h nu 0 x. Now here this we can take it as plus half and minus half gets cancelled, and in this case in the second bracket we can have this as a square minus b square, where a is equal to v2 plus half and b is equal to v1 plus half. If we put b is equal to v1 plus half and a is equal to v2 plus half, we will get a square, this as a square and this as a b square. So it will be a square minus b square, which can be written as a plus b into a minus b. A simple mathematical relation. So that we can write this particular quantity inside the second bracket in a different way. So we can have this as v2 minus v1 over here. So this bracket we can change it as small simple bracket as v2 minus v1 into h nu 0 minus this side we can write it as a plus b into a minus b. Here it will be a plus b will be a is v2 plus half plus b is v1 plus half. So v1 plus half, this is our a plus b into a minus b. A is v2 plus half, b is v1 plus half. So minus b means minus v1 minus half. This is into h nu 0 xe as a common term. So in this case again plus half and minus half gets cancelled. We will have v2 minus v1 h nu 0 minus this side it will be v2 plus v1 plus half 1. So it will be v1 plus v2 plus 1 into v2 minus v1 into h nu 0 x. So here what we can take is this v2 minus v1 h nu 0. Here also we have v2 minus v1 h nu 0. So these terms can be common for both of them, so that we can take it outside. We will have v2 V2 minus V1 into H nu 0 as common. So this will become 1 minus this side, we will put it into bracket, as this we have remaining, that is V1 plus V2 plus 1, and this side we will have XE remaining. So it will be XE. This will be our delta E, general expression for delta E. Let this be our equation number 2. So for anharmonicity constant, this will become the general expression for finding out the change in vibrational energy. So this equation will be giving us, the equation number 2 will be giving us the change in vibrational energy for an anharmonic oscillator. Now we can have the selection rules for this, same as what we had done it for previously, but here the selection rules are little different for anharmonic oscillator. For harmonic oscillator, we had selection rules as delta V is equal to plus or minus 1. But here for anharmonic oscillator, selection rules are delta V will be equal to plus or minus 1, plus or minus 2, plus or minus 3, and so on. So all the transitions from any level to any higher levels are allowed here in anharmonic oscillator, which was not the case with harmonic oscillator. For harmonic oscillator, we have to go step by step, each step, each vibrational energy level, then only we can go to the top. Here it is not that. Here we can have from any level, we can go to any other levels. But what we have to remember is that at room temperature, majority or almost all molecules are in ground state. So they are in state V is equal to 0. Now when they are in V is equal to 0 state, it cannot go down. We cannot have a state where V is equal to minus 1 or minus 2. So delta V cannot be minus 1, minus 2 and minus 3. Delta V can be only, it can go into the higher states only. So we will have, hence, selection rule is delta V will be equal to plus 1, plus 2, plus 3 and so on. Minus is not a question over here. So we will have only this cases where we can have the transitions going from, see, this is our vibrational energy levels. So if these are the vibrational energy levels, then molecule can go from the ground state V is equal to 0 to 1, 2, 3, 4. So V is equal to 0 to 1. 0 to 2 or 0 to 3 and so on. So these are allowed transitions. Here V is equal to 0 to 1 will be delta V is equal to plus 1, 0 to 2 will be plus 2, and 0 to 3 will be plus 3 and so on. We can have it for this anharmonic oscillators. Remember that this particular transition, we call it as fundamental mode of vibration, while these transitions, when we have it 0 to 2 or 0 to 3, these are called as overflows. This we had seen it in the first lecture of vibrational spectroscopy, where we had seen about the fundamental modes of vibrations and the overtones. Overtones hote hain ki inke jo 0 se 2 mein ya 0 se higher energy levels mein jayenge, so those we are called it as overtones, while 0 se immediately higher, any level se immediately higher levels mein jaate ho, So that is called as a fundamental mode of vibration. It may be from 0 to 1 or 1 to 2 or 2 to 3. ये सारे हमारे fundamental modes of vibration होंगे. लेकिन 0 से 2 में या 1 से 3 में या 2 से 5 में ये सारे हमारे overtones. Where delta V is more than plus 1. They, all those are overtones. While other where delta V is equal to plus 1, that are called as the fundamental mode of vibration. We will see the energy equations for each of these three cases, that is delta V is equal to plus 1, plus 2 and plus 3, one by one for anharmonic oscillator. Our equation for the anharmonic oscillator was delta E is equal to V2 minus V1 H nu 0 into 1 minus V1 plus V2 plus 1 into XE. This was the equation number 2 that we had just seen. That is our equation number 2 here. V2 minus V1 H nu 0 into 1 minus V2 V1 plus V2 plus 1 into XE. So same equation we have written it over here also. Now what we are having is, we are having different cases. Let's say case 1, where we are having V1 is equal to 0 and V2 is equal to 1. That is fundamental mode of vibration. Fundamental mode of vibrations. So what will happen with this delta E for this, that we will see it. Delta E then can be written as V2 is 1, so 1 minus 0 into H nu 0 into 1 minus V1 is 0 plus V2 is 1 plus 1 into XE. This will become 1 minus 0 is 1 into H nu 0 into 1 minus, this is 2XE. So we can write delta E for fundamental mode of vibrations as 1 minus 2XE into H nu 0. This is our delta E expression. We have E is equal to H nu. So we can have delta E is equal to H delta nu, or delta nu can be written as delta E upon H. So our delta nu will be equal to 1 minus 2 XE upon H, means this H will get cancelled. So nu 0, where nu is the vibrational frequency and this is fundamental mode of vibration for the given particular molecule. Now we can write, we have this delta nu bar in wave numbers. We can write it as 1 minus 2 XE into nu 0. In wave numbers, we can have this particular expression for fundamental mode of vibration, that is from V1 to V2, from 0 to 1. That is for case 1. If we go for case 2, where we have V1 is equal to 0 and V2 is equal to 2, that is first overtone. First overtone, we will have equation 2 can be written as delta E is equal to V2 minus V1 H nu 0 into 1 minus V1 plus V2 plus 1 XE. Now, this can be written in wave numbers as well as in the fundamental and the frequency terms as delta nu is equal to V2 minus V1. H will get cancelled. mu 0 into 1 minus v1 plus v2 plus 1 xe. This is in terms of frequency. This can be written in terms of wave numbers as delta nu bar is equal to v2 minus v1 mu 0 bar into 1 minus v1 plus v2 plus 1 xe. Let this be our equation number 3 in terms of wave numbers. We are more dealing with wave numbers in vibrational frequency, so we are converting this into wave number. Now when we substitute the values of v1 and v2 in this particular equation, we will get delta nu bar equal to v2 is 2 and v1 is 0. So 2 minus 0 into mu 0 bar 1 minus 0 plus 2 plus 1 xe. So this will be equal to delta nu bar will be equal to 2 mu 0 bar into 1 minus 3 xe. So this is our expression for the first overtone. Delta nu bar is 2 into mu 0 bar into 1 minus 3 xe, or delta nu bar is equal to 1 minus 3 xe into 2 mu 0 bar. Then for case 3, when the transition is occurring from v1 is equal to 0 to v1 is equal to 0 to v2 is equal to 3. That we call it as second overtone. For this, the expression can be taken from the equation number 3, that is delta mu bar is equal to v2 minus v1 mu 0 bar into 1 minus v1 plus v2 plus 1 into xe. When we substitute values of v1 and v2 in this equation, we will get delta nu bar is equal to v2 is 3, so 3 minus 0 mu bar 0 1 minus 0 plus 3 plus 1 xe. So this is equal to 3 mu 0 bar into 1 minus 3 xe. Or we can write it as delta mu bar is equal to 3 into 1 minus, okay, this will be 4 xe, 1 minus 4 xe into mu 0 bar. This is expression for second overtone. Now when we observe the expressions for fundamental mode of vibration, first overtone and the second overtones, what we can get it as fundamental, then first overtone and the second overtone. What we will have here is the fundamental mode of vibrations delta mu bar is given as mu 0 bar, or we can have it as 1 minus 2 xe into mu 0 bar. That is fundamental mode of vibration. For first overtone, we had 2 into 1 minus 3 xe mu 0 bar. And for second overtone, we had 3 into 1 minus 4 xe mu 0 bar. Previously, we had seen that xe is of the order of 10 raised to minus 2, and mu 0 bar or mu 0 is of the order of 10 raised to 5. So when we see the orders here, it is about 10 raised to 7 is the difference between xe and mu 0. So we can say that this 2xe, 3xe, as well as the 4xe terms can be easily neglected. These are very small terms, but they give us subtle differences between them, but still they are smaller in this. So what we can say is that this fundamental mode of vibration compared with the first overtone and with the second overtone, these are of the type, here it is 1 into nu 0 bar, here it is 2 into nu 0 bar, 3 into nu 0 bar, when we ignore this 3xe, 2xe or 4xe terms. It will become 1 is to 2 is to 3. They are of the order of 1 is to 2 is to 3. So the fundamental mode of first overtone and second overtones are in the ratio of almost 1 is to 2 is to 3. Not exactly 1 is to 2 is to 3, but they are almost 1 is to 2 is to 3. This helps us in finding out a particular peak, in assigning a particular peak, whether it is a fundamental mode of vibration or it is a representing an overtone. Because if we have, say, at 600 per centimeter, if we have one particular mode of vibration is having, and similarly with a smaller intensity, if we have at around 1200 per centimeter, one another peak which is less intense, it is smaller peak at around 1200 per centimeter, we can observing, then we can say that this is first overtone of this particular fundamental vibration. And we cannot, we will then be careful in assigning this to, not assigning this to any other fundamental mode of vibrations, not other any bond vibration. Again, ye ek particular bond vibration ka overtone hai, ye hum wahan par se easily assign kar sakte hain. Just isme ek do cheeze hame dekhni hoti hai ki ek कि कोई भी फंडामेंटल मोड ऑफ वाइब्रेशन होगा उससे मल्टीपल टाइम पे 2 या 3 टाइम्स पे हमें ओवरटोन्स मिलेंगे. फर्स्ट ओवरटोन 2 टाइम्स पे मिलेगा, सेकंड ओवरटोन 3 टाइम्स पे मिलेगा. एंड सेकंड थिंग वी हैव टू ऑब्जर्व इज दैट द ओवरटोन्स आर ऑफ लेस इंटेंसिटी देन द फंडामेंटल मोड ऑफ वाइब्रेशन, बिकॉज उनका अकर होने का चांसेस कम होता है, अकरेंस कम होता है एज कम्पेयर टू फंडामेंटल मोड ऑफ वाइब्रेशन. So, उनका पीक जो हाइट होता है वो कम होता है. सो दिस वॉज विथ आवर लेक्चर ऑन अनहार्मोनिक ऑसिलेटर.